Today's story comes from a listener who's 6 months pregnant and dealing with a very difficult situation involving her mother. After setting clear boundaries, no visitors at the hospital or home for the first month after the baby is born, her mother took it personally, like very personally. What makes this especially hard is that her mom had a hysterectomy at a very young age. So it feels like she's projecting a lot of her unresolved grief onto her pregnant daughter. Her mom is now pushing boundaries, crying over missing the birth, feeling excluded because of breastfeeding, and she's even asking for a joint baby shower. Like she legit wants her friends to come and buy gifts for her, and then her daughter's friends can come buy gifts for her. It's very interesting. But all of this, as you can imagine, is taking a toll on the joy of her pregnancy. First of all, wow. This is an incredibly tough situation. If my mom was doing this to me, I would feel an enormous amount of empathy, but at the same time, I'm gonna start to resent her. She's grieving her own missed experiences, which is totally valid, that's okay, but she's also making my pregnancy about her, and she's not even considering me. Well, that would feel like extremely hurtful and suffocating. It would be hard for me to keep resentment at bay. And that resentment, like I have talked about before, breaks down the most strongest, like most important relationships in our lives. So I would have to do something. If this were me, I would honestly write my mom a heartfelt letter. Like you can talk to her if that's what you're more comfortable with, but for me, I would like to get it all out on paper, all my thoughts without interruptions. And here's an idea of what you might say to her. Mom, I have so much empathy for what you have been through. I can't imagine how hard it must have been to have a hysterectomy at such a young age and missing out on all those experiences. I am beyond grateful that you adopted me, raised me, loved me. Like you're my mom. I love you so much. I've already explained the reasons why we're having an intimate birth and why we're taking precautions for the first month. It's for the baby's health and just for our peace of mind. I can see that there's a lot coming up for you in terms of the baby shower, the breastfeeding, and the birth itself. And it feels like to me it's unresolved grief. I would really recommend you talking to somebody. It can be a therapist, a minister, just anybody, because I don't want this to hurt our relationship. You have gone through so much, and now it feels like you're kind of putting that on me, and that's not fair. You cannot live those lost experiences through me. I want you to be my mom and my baby's grandmother. I don't want another mother beside me. And if we don't work through this, I know we're gonna look back on this time like with huge amounts of regret. This lets her know, Mom, I love the heck out of you, but I'm holding firm on my boundary because it's essential for my well-being and my family's health. Once you've written the letter or had the conversation encouraging your mom to seek professional help or help of some sort, the next step is for you to mind your boundary when she starts projecting like all of her grief or feelings about the situation like onto you during one of your daily phone calls. If and when she goes down that road, you can lovingly say, Mom, I love you so much, and that's why I'm going to end the conversation right now. We're just going down the wrong path. This is my pregnancy, and I'm really sorry that you didn't get to experience these things, but my advice still stands. I hope and pray that you will consider talking to a professional to work through your own loss, and I guess I'm going to talk to you tomorrow. By consistently responding this way, you're showing her that you're not going to engage in conversations that make your pregnancy about her grief. It is not about rejecting her feelings, but it's about protecting your peace and keeping your relationship healthy. Over time, if you hold this boundary firmly and kindly, she is going to understand that this pattern is not going to continue. Something I want you to consider is that it is really important that you support your mom, but it's so crucial that you take care of yourself. Your mom's grief is so real, but it is not yours to carry. Encourage her to seek professional help processing those emotions so that they don't overwhelm your relationship. You deserve to enjoy your pregnancy in this new chapter without the weight of unprocessed grief. I hope this helps, and I know that other listeners might be experiencing something similar to this. It is such a hard balance to have empathy and boundaries, but they both do exist. You can love your mom while still protect your peace. And for anyone in the Mind Your Boundary community, if you've been through something similar, maybe your parent just projected any of their unmet dreams or unrealized dreams onto you, please share advice, your perspective, anything would help. YouTube thinks you'll love this one now. And until next time, friends, make sure you keep minding your boundaries. Bye.